From this moment on, you will now be known as Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh ha ha!
Welcome, brother Sharkbait!
Sharkbait! Ooh ha ha!
Enough of the Sharkbait.
Sharkbait! Ooh, bop, bado.
Hey everybody, this is the Assistant Chiefy, D from Brooklyn, with my latest YouTube update. I'm completely taking apart my 20-gallon extra-high planted tank, and I'm going to re-landscape it, and I'm replacing the gravel with dirt. That's right, dirt. What I've noticed is, what I was using for the last 5 years was gravel, and a fertilizer that we use with aquarium gravel called lateralite. Only a little bit, but over time, the plants will use this material up and become dependent on you fertilizing it with chemicals such as, XL and Carbon Plus and Root Tabs. And being the naturalist that I am, we can't have none of that. So, taking the advice of some of you guys out there, I'm replacing the soil with dirt and fluorite sand. So, follow me on this journey as I walk you through some of the steps that I take, and let's see how it comes out. All right, here we go. Okay, so here we go. Planted tank upgrade. All right, now as you can see, I've taken my baby apart. It's one of those things where you can't really even think about how many fish you got until you got to empty the tank. What a pain in the butt. But anyway, I'm draining the tank. I got all my plant stock I've removed. I'm going to be replacing the substrate I have now, which is gravel and lateralite rather mix, with soil and fluorite sand. So I've removed all of the stuff from the tank. My plants, unfortunately, have grown up around the wall. That's going to be tricky. I was planning on just taking the tank down and cleaning it out, but gonna have to come up with something else. Swords, some rocks, my driftwood, things like that I've taken out. I'm gonna scrub them with fresh water, and we'll see how it comes out. I'm pretty clear as to what I want and what I expect, and I've done this a long time ago, so it's gonna take a little time, but all right, this is the emptying phase, so just bear with me and I'll go to phase two. Okay, phase two. Here's one thing that I want to take a look at. The root structure in this tank is like incredible. First of all, there's no dirt in this tank, but if you look down, you'll see that from the leaves that have broken down as the plants have shed and regrown back, it's like a mulch. You would think that there's dirt mixed in with gravel, but I never added dirt to this tank. That is just the decomposition of leaves and roots and bark and things that have broken down in the tank. I don't supplement this tank with anything, but I used to use a all-in-one, like a carbon supplement, but I actually stopped using that and just relied on water changes and fish waste. As you can see, if you look at my filter, this stuff is thick, you know, very thick. It's like mulch. This is one of the concerns with a planted tank and cleaning it, and also very, very, very careful thought in what kind of filtration you use. This is just an aqua clear, which I found is more than suitable for this. Some people use a canister. I don't use the canisters because I clean my filters a lot more than normal because of this buildup. That is from about a week and a half buildup. So canisters get really, really time consuming. This basically, I take it out, rinse it out. Oh wow, look at that. Roots have actually grown to the side of this thing. In the last week, look at this root spread out from the plants holding on to the filter. But anyway, I find out with this type of system, you're more likely going to clean the filter because it's so easy. A canister, you got to shut it down, take the canister out, move it to the sink, empty it, yada, yada, yada. Not for me. A lot of healthy growth. I'm going to do some pruning, but more of my focus was on just keep in mind when you plant, when you set up for a planted tank, the roots. The roots in a narrow tank are a big concern. A big tank, not so much. In a narrow tank, as you can see, the root structure for this is enormous. And I'm going to have to prune this back. So All right, phase two is the cleanup phase. I got to remove all this gravel, get those fish out, because I wasn't about to chase them in an half-empty tank for about an hour. So I'm going to just empty it down to the bare minimum and then remove the fish. And we will come right back. All right, bear with me. All right, YouTube, this is D, and I'm back. And you would never believe the night I had. Everything with the tank was going great until I noticed that my sewer was backing up. Yeah, isn't that great? I thought it was the tank smelling. It was the sewer backing up all week. But anyway, I'm going to handle that. Roto-Rooter's coming, and that's a different story. So here's the tank. As you can see, the fluorite black is in the tank. I mixed it with some unfertilized garden soil. The soil is underneath this thick layer. I got about a 2-inch layer of fluorite black, the fine stuff. And I'm starting to put my plants back in. Well, I've been delayed because of this sewer problem, but as you can see, I've cleaned all the algae off the glass. I've got my bamboo rescaped in here. The roots in the bamboo are very narrow, so they weren't a problem. My plants that were growing out, oh, they had a lot of trimming. As you can see, a lot of it had to be cut back. It was way too long and still way too long. I'm gonna trim that back. And this is the tank, so I got about a half inch of soil in there covered by 2 inches of fluorite black. This stuff is supposed to be pretty good. We're gonna see how it is. My fish are held up here. I hope fishes don't have noses because it smells in here, and I'm multitasking now. So never say D isn't dedicated to his YouTube videos. I'm walking around in boots. Floor is a mess. And no, it wasn't a fish tank. Oddly enough, when you get water on the floor, everybody assumes it was a fish tank. This time it was the other way around. Sewer's been backing up, and I'm taking care of that. So, okay, here's the beginning of the landscape. As you can see, I have my old trusty driftwood in there. And this is going to be my centerpiece. So it'll look much better when the lights are on. Background is nice and clean, and the glass is clean. All right. Time for the next phase, I guess phase three. Alright YouTube, here's the completed product. It's been running for a while. I actually stopped and tested the water parameters. I tested the pH. It's about 1 point off of what the tank water was. So I've adjusted it a little bit and added some stress coat actually to it. Since I completely changed the substrate and everything, I'm sure the water chemistry is going to be different, even though the pH and everything is the same. My boys are still hanging in there. They're doing okay. Thank you, Tetra, for having that pump. This way, you know, most fish people have tons of equipment that they have sitting around. I have been in there, they've been running. Oh yeah, sewer guy came, that's cleaned up. Have to mop the floor, everything else is done. Just to give you an update on that, the damnedest things happen, right? So catastrophe averted. And while he was cleaning the sewer, I was setting up my tank. And that, is that a true aquarist or what? So I have some wisteria that I added in there. I had some wisteria before. I know it's a pain in the neck, so all of you guys say, oh my god, he put wisteria in there. I'm using wisteria for two reasons. A, because I completely changed the substrate, and wisteria will absorb a lot of the excess nutrients from the new soil. I'm going to get the chemistry balanced out, so I may be removing it, but I do use wisteria for that reason. Cabambia, I stripped it down to the bare minimum, not what I used to have. I stripped it down a lot. My anubis plants, I cleaned them off. They're doing fine. I trimmed this back a heck of a lot. No more growing up the wall like a freaking little shop of horrors. My bamboo is in there and is squared away. I'm gonna have to move it back because the light's gonna go back up here. And we're about ready to get it clean. As you can see, the water's been running for about 3 hours. I had the filter running. Clear that water out crystal clear. Thank you, Aqua Clear. And phase four complete. Substrate is nice and clean. I did break the arm off of Sandy, but you know, who's gonna notice Sandy has one arm missing? I got my people back in there. My daughter loves them, so they gotta find a place in everything in the tank. So what are you gonna do? All right, let's get it back to where it was. Let me get those fish acclimated. All right. Keep telling me.